Well, this is a message to Senator Claire McCaskill of Missouri. As a Missouri resident, she is my only Democrat elected official. And whether I voted for her or not, as my elected official, she still represents me. And I speak to her concerning the NSA spying and the secrecy and the blanket surveillance, specifically as a Democrat, because when George W. Bush did it, the Democrats raised holy hell. They didn't do anything about it, they just raised hell. Now, when the Democrat president is doing it, the Democrats are surprisingly or unsurprisingly silent. And so I'm calling her out to call her party out and her president out about this blanket surveillance and the lack of transparency, which is the opposite of what the Obama campaign was all about. And the whole mess of the revelations about the NSA spying is it's theater, because one, nothing new was revealed. You know, the only thing in danger of dying or getting shot at is the reputations of the people who are keeping it secret and pretending that they're doing it for our benefit. No human lives are in danger of revealing what has already been revealed. You know, it is no secret that the American government has been collecting emails and collecting phone numbers and honestly, God knows what else. And the terrorists of all people are the ones going about their business despite this, or in spite of this. And so they obviously are not even bothered by the spying itself. It's on American citizens. It's not on people in Yemen. It's not on people in Somalia or Afghanistan or Iran. It's on the United States citizens. And something that I have not heard anybody ask is the fact that it takes a foreign intelligence surveillance court to get a warrant to wiretap and surveil United States citizens. You know, why is it not a domestic intelligence surveillance court? It raises other questions. And to have representatives go about saying that, you know, we're your elected officials, we're elected to be trusted with this information for you so that you don't have to, we can keep you safe and we can keep it secret. Well, why is it then when certain elected officials get their hands on this information, they say the American people would be shocked to find out what is going on here and not say joyous or thankful or understanding? No politician has ever run on the ticket of elect me and I will ensure that the United States government spies on you and your neighbor without you knowing it, whether you are guilty or not and whether there's a warrant or probable cause or not. So no politician has ever been elected on this, and no politician will ever run on that. And they know that the American people do not appreciate this, and yet they will try and sell to the American people that the American people should be grateful to them for doing this without them knowing it, and it's for their protection, and 9/11 and Jesus and, you know, God bless America, blah 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 bullshit. The information that's being gathered, you know, is really of no use to the government. There is no point for the government itself to need records of the general populace, because the general populace doesn't really talk about anything worth talking about. They're mostly consumerist in their speech and in their actions, and so it seems more corporate interest to be interested in emails and online habits. You know, for example, it's Microsoft Xbox Kinect that is looking into people's rooms and not, say, government issue vehicle safety or something like that. You know, it's corporate interest looking into people's private lives. And the United States government is really just a corporation. It is run by people who do not view themselves as one of us. It is a, you know, look at minimum wage. Because if they were paying their equals, or those they believe are one of them, it would be millions of dollars, you know. Because the people themselves are the real job creators and wage creators and money makers and all of this. It is not the few people who get paid the millions and billions of dollars. So if they considered us to be equals and perhaps even fellow citizens, then we all would be paid millions and millions of dollars, and there wouldn't really be a class gap or anything like that. And so logic speaks. Anybody who's been paying attention the past few years knows the spying has been going on. The more the politicians feed the same bullshit, the less likely they are to be paid attention to, and of course Congress's approval rating will continue to go down. Eventually change will come. I mean, that is the nature of my generation, is to get rid of the old and make sure it doesn't happen again. And good job, Edward Snowden. Thank you.